In this problem, we're given a vertical Atwood machine and the heavier mass is already resting on the ground, and this means nothing is going to happen. It's not going to accelerate. But we're asked a couple interesting questions. We want the tension in the string and we want to get the normal force on the big mass. So let's start by just doing some force diagrams. Gravity is certainly pulling down on the little mass, mg. And there's another force on m. The reason it's not falling is that the tension is pulling up on it. And I tried to show those two forces sort of qualitatively equal in magnitude because I know the net force on little m is zero because it's not accelerating. Then I look at big M. And of course, gravity pulls down on big M, but it's a bigger mass, so I made that longer. And the tension in the string is the same everywhere, provided the pulley is light and frictionless. So I want to make that about the same length as my first tension vector. And so far, if I look at the forces on big M, well, gravity's winning, but there's one force that I haven't done yet, and it's the normal force of the floor pushing up on M. Now, if I look at the sum of those two upward forces, it better be equal to the weight of that block in order for that block to not be accelerating. Then we apply Newton's second law to each of the masses. That's F net equals MA, and the acceleration is zero. Nothing is happening here. So I could use a sign convention of upward equals positive, downward equals negative, and say that the analysis on little m is T minus mg is equal to zero. And that comes out to saying that tension is equal to little mg, and we have half of our question done. Alternatively, we could just say, hey, I know this thing isn't accelerating, so the upward and downward forces better balance each other. So F up is equal to F down. That gets you to the same answer, so either way. All right, what about big M? Again, just to be a little more formal about it, I write down F net equals MA, but there's no acceleration, so the right-hand side is zero there. And my upward forces are N and T, so I'm going to count those both as positive, and then big MG, the force of gravity, I'll count as negative, and this better sum to zero. And what I'm after here is the normal force, so just solving for that, I add mg to both sides and subtract t from both sides, and I replace t with what I found in the analysis of the little mass. It's little mg. And I can factor out g, and I get g times the quantity m minus m. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.